It's going to be an intimate setting. Put the candles on it.
Wow, well, thanks you guys for coming. I really appreciate it. I was expecting two people here. So I really appreciate everybody coming out. I'm going to play a couple of tracks, a couple of ministry songs. And then if you guys have any questions or anything like that, keep them to yourself. And then we're going to give away this guitar. And first I'm going to break it. People walk away with it. And I can watch it. So, it's getting my quick here. It's something I've never done before. I'm about to get a drill, like just put a pick on it. It was fucking crazy. I mean, because I had always like played, you know, heavy stuff, and I used to like play in thrash bands when I first started and shit like that. But it's nothing like this. It's brutal. Like first coming on board, the when I first met Al, like, probably in the early 2000s. I was always a huge ministry fan, and we had the same booking agent
on that tour, and Paul Raven, Tommy Victor, Mike Scoscia, and Alan Baby, and I was in Revolting Cox, and with Phil Dell, and Luke Von Acker, I think you guys were familiar with the original Revco guys or not, but it was fucking chaos on that tour, and, you know, just being thrust into that. It was a trip. So, but the Revolting Cox material was very like relaxed on your right arm, you know, very easy shit. And then after the during that tour, Al and I became very close, and so he was like, "Hey man, I'm gonna start writing the next ministry record. And you want to help me?" And I was like, "Of course." So they went to Europe. I stayed home and I'd written like a handful of song ideas. And the whole time I was just like thinking, man, if one of my riffs just ends up, you know, anywhere on the record, I'll be, you know, that'll make my fucking life. And so he flies me to El Paso when they got back. And I literally had my bags and they drive me right to the studio. And he goes, "You ready to record it solo?" And I was like, sure. You know, I mean, when you're in that kind of situation, man, you gotta just fucking like go for it, you know. And so I was like, yeah, I literally had my bag, and I was like, what do you want me to play solo on? And he plays this one song. It's called "Dying Crash." It was the only song he had written at the time for The Last Supper. And so he plays it like two times. He goes, "You ready?" And I was like, yeah. So they fucking give me a guitar and I just fucking rip into a solo. And I finish and he like comes over to me and he like picks me up and he gives me a kiss. And I'm like, dude, that was fucking killer. And I go, man, I go, let me do it again, man. I can do it way better. And he's like, no, that was perfect. I'm like, dude, that was the first fucking take. You know? And he's like, no. He's like, that's the one. And I'm like, dude, please let me do it. And he goes, all right, I'll let you do it again, but we're keeping the first one. So, sure enough, if you listen to The Last Supper, that song, "Dying Crash," that solo, that's the first take. And that's how I got, you know, officially in the ministry, was right then and there. And so after that solo,
I was joking around with somebody the other day about how I was a much better guitar player when I was 16, I think, than I am now. Because I was like, I was all about just fucking practicing, you know. But back then it was a different mentality for me because, you know, everybody wanted to be kind of like the hotshot lead guitar player back then, you know, it was in the 80s. And so I was doing a lot of solos and leads and shit like that. But I, at that same, you know, point, I started to develop my writing. Series Schecter B, which came out last January, and fucking, I love it. It's all I played this last tour, and all I'm probably gonna continue to play. For me, it's very easy to get up here, you know, a lot of stuff with ministry, I have to get way high up on the neck. I've always dug V's, and you know, last year they were like, they approached me if I was interested in having my own signature model. I was like, fuck no. I did it anyways. Like, maybe. So, but yeah, we're gonna be giving this one away later, and then there's, you know, it's available here also to purchase. So if you guys get a chance, come out and check it out, and you know, play it and stuff.
To the studio that use. How do you translate the method that you use to record in the studio to live on stage? I mean, to create that same sound.
The same kind of
thing. Eruption, right?
Right.
Did you ever write your own instrumental, and if you did, could you play it?
You know what? I never really did.
Oh, okay.
Because I was like, back, I was too young back then to really like have any decent recording. It was like my little Batman 4 track.
Sure.
So yeah, with all the band, like when I got my first record, as much as we can, but no, I didn't have anything like that. So. Any other questions? Oh, we're also giving away some ministry tickets to our New Year's Eve show in Chicago. So, yeah.
Where are you guys playing?
The Concord.